I really just want to get into the essence of how I edit a photo, and I think you'll be surprised at how little I do to my photography. Hey everyone, today I wanted to do a quick video to talk about how I edit my photos in Lightroom. One of the reasons I like Lightroom, not Lightroom Classic, is because I can do it on cloud. I can do it on my computer, I can do it on my phone, I can do it on my iPad. And having that kind of flexibility is really important. So one of the things that prevented me from doing editing in the past was I just didn't want to do the work. I would take a bunch of photos, I would have all these photos to look at, and then, you know, I wouldn't do it. To make editing much easier, you know, there's batch things that you can do in here, but I won't get into batch today. I really just want to get into the essence of how I edit a photo. And I think you'll be surprised at how little I do to my photography. So I guess with that, let's just jump right in. Right now I've pulled up images I took on Father's Day. So this was Sunday, June 16th, 2024. I don't take a lot of the same photos. So like here's an instance where I took several different versions of a photo where I was trying to frame people walking through this like kiosk. And that's one instance where I'll take several, but several to me is four. You know, a lot of people out there will just hit that rapid fire on their camera and then they have 100. And I don't know how you edit that. I don't know how you go through and pick the one out of the 100 that's like the one. Anyway, how I edit photos on an iPad. Actually, this is how I edit photos, period. I just prefer using my pencil on my iPad because there's something about, you know, touching your photos that feels very organic. I just really like being able to do that. The pencil's just a mouse. If you don't want to use Lightroom, I get it. Subscription fees stink. There's plenty of options out there. Let me show you a couple of those. So one of the ones I use is Darkroom. Darkroom actually attaches itself to your iPhoto library, which can be okay. But you can go into your DNG files and raw images. Sorry, I'm trying to find raw. I'll just go right over to the raw. All right, so if I have a raw image, to get to the pieces I use the most, it's just under light. So adjustments in Darkroom or in Apple Photos, I can go to raw and in here, edit, exposure, brilliant, or exposure, highlights, shadows, contrast. These are what you're looking for. This is any app that you use. All you're looking for are those basic tools. So I'm gonna switch back over to Lightroom because this is where I do most of my work. So in this particular scene, I'm trying to get you to, you know, see all the layers of the reflections that I got. One of the things that I'll do is actually pull back exposure and pull up the contrast and notice how little I do. I don't go nuts, right? I like to keep it very subtle. The image is already something that I'm fairly happy with. I'm just trying to bring out a little more of it. I'm gonna pull the shadows down, pull the whites up, relax. And then I will often go into color and I'll just probably tweak this a little toward blue to get some of that green out. But I do want to maintain the green in this area here. This is, you know, kind of the star of the show in this picture. And then effects, I often will pull a little dehaze and just a little clarity just to keep things clear. Okay, so that's what I have for this image. Now, there's a couple of other things that I like to do. I am unapologetically a cropper. And so right now you'll notice that I'm at 4:3. I've been shooting in 4:3 lately because after my printing, I've decided that 2:3 is not the aspect I'm looking for really. So I actually shoot my camera in 4:3 now, but it retains all the information. You can see if I go to original 3:2 that it retained all that information, but I shoot in 4:3, so it's actually closer to what I was looking for in the first place. So all I'll do in this is just, you know, the bricks don't add anything to the image, and that's essentially it. I'll just do that and then I'll probably straighten it out a little. Okay. Most of the time, this is all I do. This is good to me. But something I did do on this particular image was, and again, this is, you know, a little more advanced with color grading about highlights, shadows, and midtones, and I could do a whole different video on that, but I created one where I color corrected a little more to what I wanted. And what I did in this one was I went into color grading, and in the highlights, I pulled it more toward blue because I wanted these whites in here to be blue, but I didn't want that green to go away. So I couldn't just use the color temperature slider for white balance. I needed something else to give me the blue that I was looking for. And then these brown bars, I wanted them to be a little more rust colored, including this area back here. I wanted this to be more red. So that's what I did here. Just very subtle tones to the shadows. And that is how I color graded this particular picture. So if I press and hold, that's the picture right out of the camera, which I think is pretty close to what I wanted. But I, you know, this one gives me a little bit more of that layer that I'm looking for. So that's what I do when I edit photos. I usually don't do, I just kind of wanted to show that there's more that you can do than just the light sliders, but it's in the light sliders that you'll find a lot of people make a lot of mistakes. So in here, you'll see people really bump up the contrast and they'll pull way back on the, you know, they're going too crazy with these. And what they end up getting is something that doesn't quite look right. A lot of fringing, a lot of weird stuff going on in areas that were unexpected. And another thing that I see just way too much of is people go crazy with the dehaze too. So I've taken an image that I thought looked pretty decent, and I've done something with it. Now some people are really into this like gritty blue scene. That's, I see it in Instagram, I see it all over the place. That's a cool looking style today. That's something you have to remember. Is that a cool style today? Will you look at that style in a book 50 years from now and go, wow, that style is really good? Or will you look at that style and go, that was shot in 2022, 2023, 2024, because everybody was doing that? You probably want to get away from doing stuff like that. Now, if that's your goal, then more power to you. It's a very easy thing to accomplish using those more advanced features. In fact, I have a preset that I called Blue Grit, just because I wanted to be able to see if I could do it. So my preset Blue Grit is the top one. And there's that blue grit that I'm talking about, that sort of blue gritty. It's fine. I use it occasionally when I'm sort of stuck on an image. There's the essence of my editing. I will go in and I will do minor adjustments. This one, I didn't do anything to color grading or color mix. You can see color grading is not, has not been futzed with. Neither has color mix. If there is settings, there'd be little white dots underneath. I haven't done anything to any of those. So the only thing I did in this particular photo was adjust the light. I'll show you that. This is how it came out of camera. I just wanted to darken it. I wanted to add some vibrance to the colors. Contrast is the slider for that. And I wanted the shadows to be more prevalent, because that was actually what caught my eye when I went there. It wasn't the color in the canopy, it was the shadows on the ground. So that's what I wanted to give more prevalence to. Contrast, exposure, highlights, shadows. Shadows, if I want them darker, I have to pull them down, right? I don't want them to look unnatural, so I keep them there. Highlights, I actually had to pull down quite a bit because of what's going on in the sky. If I reset that to zero, it looks a little too blown out. So I just pulled it back until I got some blue from the sky. That's it. Remember, if you enjoy stuff like this, if you enjoy content like this, please remember to like and subscribe. It always helps with the channel. And also let me know in the comments if you want to see me do more of this kind of stuff. I love talking about the stuff I've learned. I love talking about how I shoot and how I edit. So, you know, let me know if that's something that would interest you. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you got something from it. And, you know, feel free to leave me your comments on how you edit. I love to learn new stuff. And I guess thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.